Andrew here, Sterilizer Autoclave Solutions, 704-966-1650, option 3 for free technical support. So we're going to talk about Charlie 232 error code. Fill mode, water low. Items not sterile, push stop to restart. Boom, boom. Water level sensor did not detect water within 5 minute time limit. So a couple obvious things is the reservoir water level is low. Ours is empty in this case, but if your water is in the red, it might not fill, especially after, if you're doing back-to-back cycles, it probably will not fill at all. So you're gonna wanna add the water up to here, and then you're gonna wanna start another cycle and see if the problem persists. The problem persists, it could be that you have a chamber filter is clogged. So we're gonna pull all the trays out. The chamber filter is part of your preventative maintenance, probably weekly. Let's go. Okay, that's pretty tough. You might want a pair of pliers in some cases to get that out. So we're gonna take the chamber, everything out of the chamber. As you can see back here, here's a chamber filter. So as a part of your weekly maintenance or bi-weekly maintenance, you're gonna take this chamber filter, make sure it's not clogged. You're gonna hold it up to the light, make sure you can see through it, run some water over it, scrub it with a toothbrush, and reinsert. It fits back right in the center hole. Don't do any of this while this is hot because you'll get burnt. Okay, so the chamber filter is clogged. We're gonna check to see if it's dirty, clean and replace as necessary. We can run a speed clean cycle. That I would do that monthly. I'll show you that in another video on how to do that. It could be the water level sensor is malfunctioning or dirty. So back in the center here, this little disc, that's the water level sensor. So if you're getting this error in the right when you install the unit, it could be that your unit is not on a level surface. If it's not on a level surface and it's kind of leaning forward a little bit, it'll fill up in the front and won't fill up in the back, and you might get an error that way. It could also be dirty, which really has something to do with the grounding circuit. So before you do anything inspecting the ground circuit, to go into more detail, just give us a call at our free tech support line. We can help you through that. Clean, dry with level sensor. Okay, air valve malfunctioning or dirty. So the air valve, I got a lot of junk here on the table, but basically the air valve is back here. There's a valve back here that opens and closes as the chamber condenses. You will have to take the top cover off. You will have to take the back panel off to inspect that. That's more of a technician service repair. End users can perform it. We have some videos, but I recommend calling us first. So air valve malfunctioning or dirty. We also can go into diagnostic mode. It's in here into the computer, and we can test and make sure that that is engaging. We really can't tell if it's dirty. Basically, you put it in diagnostic mode and you hit the start button, you get to a certain point and you test to make sure that it's clicking. Fill valve malfunctioning or dirty. We're gonna inspect the fill valve related tubing for restrictions. Clean and replace fill valve. Inspect two wires connecting to the fill valve and PC board for damage and or loose connections. Secure, repair loose or damaged connections. So this valve in the front is the fill valve. There's a lot of different versions of the Midmark M11. Some of them have a rectifier in between the board and the fill valve. Sometimes those go bad. This style has the rectifier built into it, so we can't test it. You can ohm it out with an ohm meter and see if it's working and see if it's ohming out, but it could be the coil itself, could be the plunger on the inside is stuck or the spring is bad, could be the rectifier. Last case, it could be the PC board. I don't think it's that. But as we see here on the manual, it says PC board malfunctioning, verify voltage to fill valve, perform fill valve supply voltage test. Basically, we'll put it into service diagnostic mode, we'll unplug these two wires and we'll plug a voltmeter into it, and then we'll engage the valve and we'll make sure power is going in. Again, that's probably a technician to do. If you're a handyman, we'll walk you through it. Chamber is dirty or corroded. That's pretty obvious. This is a new unit, so that's not the case. But if you're not draining the water on these units and you're always adding water, then you've got a bunch of biofilm at the bottom of this reservoir and it's working its way into the valves, maybe causing fill issues like we're talking about, or it can get into the chamber and it's burning to the sidewalls, burning to the eating element. Your unit's running out, you know, cooking the instruments instead of sterilizing them. So chamber dirty, inspect the bottom of the chamber, clean bottom of the chamber with speed clean. We have that on our website. And distilled water or water that meets referenced water purity specifications and user guide. Okay, so a restricted condensing coil. The condensing coil's inside of the reservoir. You have to take the back panel off, the top cover off, a couple other things. I will have a video for that, but if anything, just give us a call or send it in for repair. Check for blockage in coil. Assure weep hole is present and not obstructed. There's a weep hole at the bottom, underneath the bottom of the coil. I'll get into detail at another date. Blockage or malfunction in the VistaCool system, if used, check for debris or blockage in the tubing fittings of the VistaCool system. If you have a VistaCool system, that could be an issue too. Give us a call. We can walk you through that. You have to check operation of the inline thermal sensor. You have to check for weep hole in the manifold lid and threaded area on the tank of the VistaCool system. Check the position of tank for proper installation. Basically, let's just hope for your sake that you don't have enough water in here, because it could be a whole mess of errors for Charlie 232 error code. We'd like to help you out with any and all. We can kind of go through it together and narrow down what the problem is. If you like this video, please share it. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos, and have a great day.